Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This week, I'm going to go for a completely different topic to normally. Normally focus on something around Tyneside, Tyne and Wear, but today we're going to look at a bit further afield. So I recently went on a trip up to Scotland, up to the Forth Bridge. This is really awe-inspiring sight to see. The UNESCO World Heritage Site, and so I'm going to talk about the history and sort of the construction of this bridge. The Forth Bridge is located on the Firth of Forth. This has always posed sort of a major navigational barrier between Edinburgh and Northern Scotland. As you can see, the sort of inlet of the river really just cuts the sort of any lines of transportation in half. And crossing this, time constraint to travel. The first crossing of the Forth by railway actually came in 1850. The Edinburgh, Leith and Granton Railway started the world's first train ferry. So this is when the train pulls up. Normally it's loaded completely onto a boat. So the train carriages are loaded onto the boat, which then travels to the other side, and then the train carriages are unloaded onto a new train and off it goes. Obviously there's still a delay in this, it's not as quick as having a sort of straight bridge over. This was designed by Thomas Booch, and this was to take railway coaches between Granton and Burntisland. So then this was followed in 1873, the North British Railway obtained an authority to build a railway bridge across the Firth of Forth. This led to the design of, so this was obviously designed by Thomas Booch, and Thomas Booch's original bridge across the Tay collapsed in a storm in December 1879. So therefore the work on the Forth Bridge stopped immediately, and this was sort of pending a full inquiry. So then Thomas Booch's suspension bridge plans were completely abandoned in 1881, as his sort of overall credibility of designing these sort of bridges was just thrown up in the air. Therefore, there was still a need to design a bridge over the Firth of Forth, so designs for a new bridge were invited by the newly formed Forth Bridge Railway Company. This Forth Bridge Railway Company consisted of the North British Railway, the Midland Railway, the North Eastern Railway, and the Great Northern Railways. The new proposals for a crossing of the Firth of Forth between South Queensferry and North Queensferry. This was designed to make use of the island of Inchgarve. The design also had to ensure that the Forth remained a navigable river, as there was a lot of sort of industry as well as naval ship bases up river. And the design also had to remain rigid and stiff, unlike Thomas Booch's design over the River Tay, which collapsed in a storm. This bridge needed to be stormproof to prevent the shipping channel from being completely blocked if it collapsed, and obviously to keep the shipping canal completely open. It also had to be able to transport the heaviest freight trains. So in regards to the design of it, the work started on construction in 1883. The Forth Bridge has three double cantilevers with two 1700 foot suspended spans between them. At the time, these were the longest spans in the world. The rail level is 46 meters above high water. Each tower has four steel tubes, which are 3.7 meters in diameter and reaches a height of 110 meters above high water. The foundations extend 89 feet below the riverbed. The total length of the bridge is 2,467 metres, and this includes its approach viaducts. So this was the first major construction to be made of steel, costing £3 million to build at the time, and employing a workforce of 4,600 men. And unfortunately, due to the sort of nature of construction industry at the time, sort of safety precautions we're used to at the minute weren't there. This led to a large number of men actually fatally losing their lives during the construction of this bridge. A memorial is actually dedicated to them on the South Queensferry side of the river. Constant rumour of the Forth Bridge is that once you finish painting it, they have to start repainting it. This rumour is always held either between the Forth Bridge or the San Francisco Golden Gate Bridge. But both have sort of overcome this problem in modern years. In 2001, a major refurbishment project occurred on the Forth Rail Bridge. Over 10 years, the bridge was covered in scaffolding with special screening to sort of prevent debris from falling into the watercourse beneath and any contamination or pollution there. The paint was then actually sandblasted off completely back to the original metal, and then any maintenance necessary was undertaken on the bridge structure. This was all done before new paintwork was applied. This paint was then applied in three coats, which were sort of three protective layers. This meant the structure would not have to be painted for at least 20 years. So in 2015, the site was actually designated a World Heritage Site by UNESCO. This is held to other such high accords such as the Taj Mahal, the Great Wall of China. So the bridge is owned and maintained by Network Rail, a and is used by ScotRail and other services such as LNER. Balfour Beatty actually undertake the maintenance on behalf of Network Rail, which are a major construction firm in Scotland. Even though this bridge was built over 100 years ago, this still carries 190 to 200 train movements each day.